Hello everyone, I'm Fethan Atik Bahar, postdoctoral researcher from the Tunisia Polytechnic School, University of Carthage. And I'm very glad to talk about the topic of technico-economic analysis of large-scale offshore wind farms in Tunisia to be implemented in the Tunisian coastline between the cities of Sfax and Gabs, and share with you a few results conducted by our research team from the Applied Mechanics and System Laboratory last month. Also, it's worth to mention that this is a collaborative project between the Tunisia Polytechnic School and the Pan-Africa University, the Institute of Water, Energy and Energy Sciences, with the team of myself, Fatna Tik Bahar, Ahmed Suhaib Ben Habti, and Malik Sahrawi. Next slide. Wind energy is one of the most important compounds of the green transition in Tunisia, and it has been given a lot of attention since 2000. In fact, Tunisia has good wind energy conditions, and wind power density in the north and the southeastern regions is ranging between 820 watt per meter and 774 watt per meter, respectively. Also, favorable wind sites are found in the north coast, as you can see in the picture or in the figure on the left side, as well as in the center and in the southern region of the country. For example, for an altitude of 100 meter and a resolution of 1 kilometer, the Global Wind Atlas, as shown in both figures here, indicate that the northwest of the country, the wind speed are between 6 meters per second and 7 meters per second in the coastal area, especially in the north part of the country. Wind speed can reach 7 meters per second, and the south, the wind speed can reach 8 meters per second. The speeds indicate good potential for wind energy activities and development of these sites. In the following slide, as you can see, we have in the figure one and the figure two, they are representing the wind speed potential that we can see. And you can see a lot of red area that also mentioned that there is a good potential of wind. For example, here in this figure, in the red regions mention that there is a good wind potential, as you can see, meter per second. And the blue area could mention that those places are not suitable for wind activities. And you can see that in Tunisia along the coastline, also in the south, there is a good wind potential. And then the second figure here, this one is presenting the wind density, the wind power density in Tunisia. And we can see that there is a good potential in many areas of the countries. For example, the coastline, the northern part, and also in some northern part. For example, some southern part. Sorry. While talking about the offshore wind potential in Tunisia, after conducting a literature review that proved the interest and the benefits of implementing offshore wind energy in Tunisia, the studied site was selected, and then wind potential was assessed, and the wind energy yield of large-scale offshore wind farm of 100 megawatt was calculated using WindPro software. WindPro software is a commercial software that allows to calculate the energy yield for wind farms, for onshore and offshore wind farms. It could use a range of data. There are also the online data that we use for the study, and also we can also include in WindPro some measurement data. For us, the selection of the site was based on several criteria, including first, sufficient space for the installation and required number of turbines, optimal water depth, and this, as you can see in the first map here, that according to literature review, Tunisia could be among the part of the world that there is possibility to have offshore activity according to this depth of water, which is less than 50 meters. In addition to this, we considered also the proximity to the area with high electricity consumption, the good wind potential, and the good accessibility, and also that our implementation will not cause any environment risk. To carry out our economic feasibility study of large-scale offshore wind farm to be implemented in Tunisia coastline between the cities of Sfax and Gabs by estimating the levelized cost of electricity, the energy yield of the wind farms was calculated used WindPro software. Here also it's worth to mention that the energy yield was verified, and we found that the capacity factor from WindPro and from the Wind Atlas are very close. Also, we use for the study available online data, and the LCO model was developed using local data relevant to renewable energy framework and also to the local market expansion in Tunisia. Here in this table, we can give some of the inputs that we use for our LCO model, such as the project duration, the equity, the debt, the cost of equity, the debt interest, the VAC discount factor, and also the OPEX and the CAPEX that were calculated according to what we have in the Tunisian local market. Results from the estimated energy yield together with technical detail were used for wind turbines and incorporated in the LCO model in order to calculate the cost of electricity. And here we mention with the CPE, the cost to produce energy in a year, and each parameter is given in year. For this model, the LCO is calculated based on expected cash flows from the O&M and capital expenditures. Results show that for 1 megawatt wind farm, annual energy yield could reach 350.5 gigawatt hour, and the LCO is about 189 megawatt hour US dollar per megawatt hour. Moreover, figures 1 and 2 are showing the sensitivity analysis of the LCO calculated from deviation from the input value of the capital expenditure, the OPEX. Here the OPEX influence, and here the CAPEX influence. And we can see that the sensitivity is affected too much the cost of electricity. That's why a good estimation of both CAPEX and OPEX is very important and crucial to ensure that we are conducting a real analysis of the economic of the wind turbines, and also that we are having a good LCO values. As conclusion, the cost that we found is still high, but it's worth to mention that this LCO values could be compared to the commercial scale offshore wind project values, for example, in China and in Germany. The values of LCO in China is reported to be 138 US dollar per megawatt hour, and in Germany is 130 megawatt US dollar per megawatt hour. So thank you for your attention, and I look forward to your questions.